Hi everyone, welcome back to our new session of the UiPath. In this session, I will explain you how to create library in UiPath. So basic agenda of this session is what is library in UiPath, how to create library, how to publish it, and how we can add it in our activity panel. So we'll discuss each one by one. So let's begin with this. I've already created one example, and based on the example we will publish it, and after publishing how we can add it in this activity panel. So just like these activities are available in your sheet, if you want to add other activity based on your customized library, so you can also do that. So just like if you want to show Excel sheet, and then that Excel sheet should be converted into data table, and if you want to show that in a message box, so these steps you can record it here and publish it. After publishing you can add it. So once you will perform similar step, you can just drag and drop activity and do modification on that. After modification you will definitely going to use that. So this is example I've already created. So for you, I will definitely going to create one other activity how you can do that. So library is basically, it is available here to create reusable components and publish them together as a library. So whatever activity you have created earlier, that if you want to use it in future for your automation project or any other project, then you can use that by this library. So we have to go to start, then select library, change the name of that library, and you will come up with your coding panel. So let's wait for the workspace. Once it is available, you can start with this. Now you can see that the objective is almost same. You just have to do your activity, because once you will go to the activity, it will configure you related with the library, and it will, once you will publish, it will generate .nuget for you. So here I am going to take one read range from the workflow. I have already used that because that is showing here. Provide the Excel sheet name, where whatever Excel sheet if you want to show up or automate that Excel. So just provide the location of that Excel. Excel data selected. Now you can see sheet 1 is available. I don't want to show here the range, so I am keeping here as a blank, so it will cover up all the activity. Now you can see read range is available. Just we have to create variable. So my variable name is get result. Now it's done. Now I am dragging here append range. So here I am going to create. So once it will take a data from this Excel sheet, it will store in my variable. After storing in variable, we can add it here, final dot xls and in sheet 1, it should be available in sheet 1. Get result here. Now you can see all the warnings are resolved and my variable is assigned to the sequence. That should be variable type data table. Let's save this Now it's saved. Let's run this. After running, it will generate a NuGet packages. That NuGet packages, we will use it at the time of adding in activity panel. So I will show you where it is generated. Test data, test library 2. Still running. So because of it is library project, because of that it is taking some time. So don't worry about that, because it is comparing or adding all the required dependency in your project, so that you can use that easily in configuration. Excel file extension is wrong. It's XLSX. Yeah. Now save it again and run the file. Now you can see here one final Excel file is available with the data. Whatever data is available in my previous file, it copied that data in this file. Let me show you. Now you can see data. The file is available with the data. So our project is successful. So let's publish this. So next step, so we have covered this. What is library in UiPath? How to create library? It's already created. Now let's see how to publish that. You just have to click on the publish. So it will create a test library and with the version name. So whatever version you want, you can add it here. If you want to add release notes, you can also do that. I've already created detailed session of the how to publish your project or library. So same, you can use it for the publishing library as well. So I'm not mentioning anything here, just publish. So after publishing, you will see here one NuGet packages are available. Now it's successful. Copy to clipboard. Copy in my previous folder. Now you can see second, just now it is created. Let's cut here and paste it too. So you have just have to provide our folder location. So I pasted here. Copy their name so that we will use it for adding activity. Now our publishing activity is completed. Let's begin how to add in our activity panel. So for adding activity panel, you just go to project, or you just have to open. So these activity you can use it in other project, so that you can save your time for creating these steps. So I am using other project here which I've already created, blank process. So these are reusable components, we can use it in library. So once you will create, so you can see here project is available. If you want to add these dependency, you just go to manage. From manage, you have to select all packages, local, settings, add here. I am removing here this one. You can also do that. Just name of your package, add it to, add it to your location where your activity is available for adding. I'm selecting folder. Once you will click add, these activities available. Now you can see here you have to download it from manage activity. So third is just have to download it. So once you will download and once click on save, these activities will be available. So we have created test library 2, and at the end it will add your name, depends on your system name. So now you can see our second activity is available. So once you will click on here, you can see this activity will be available in your activity panel. And if you want to drag and drop for reusable component as a reusable component, then you can use it. So once you click on here, these activity will work according to your flow which you have created at the time of creation. So this is done. We can see that we have added activity in our activity panel. So hope you understand it. If you have any queries or comment, please comment in the comment box so that I will check and revert with the resolution. And don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the latest update. Thank you.